We're standing on the edge of the Arkansas River in Canyon City. The river's beautiful, popular, and deadly.
The safest way to enjoy the river and the waterways is to not get in.
But here I am, about to get in, with Colorado Springs firefighters as they practice swift water rescues.
You've been here all day. You've seen the look on my face. We have people here that are good in the water, people that are not very good swimmers here in the water. Planning this event is a tremendous amount of energy and time and watchful eyes.
We're here in Canyon City along the Arkansas River, and it's go time. I'm about to jump in this river and go through full swift water rescue training. Lieutenant Jason Leach with the CSFD Fire Department got me trained up, but I do have a little bit of trepidation. I'm not the strongest swimmer. This water looks cold. It's moving fast. I've got my PFD on, a wetsuit, a helmet and gloves, and we're gonna do this. I am prepared and here by choice, but my heart is beating a bit too quickly as I inch toward the water. Tell me when.
Yeah.
After the first float down in my defensive swim position, on my back with my feet headed downstream, we waste no time getting to the next life-saving training maneuver.
Float downstream, we're gonna find an eddy on the side of the bank, and the goal is for those firefighters to be able to swim in that eddy to self-rescue. After we do that portion, we're gonna come to this portion here with a little faster moving water, and that's where we wanna practice our throw bags. We're gonna send our firefighters in as swimmers going down the river that are unprotected.
Nice!
As we practice various rescue techniques, a little ways down the river, we watch several tubers get flipped into the water at this trouble spot. Lieutenant Jason Leach says this is not a new sight for his team.
It's nice to have 10 firefighters here. They're trained, they're prepared, they have the right equipment, they're ready to go, their heads are on a swivel, they're paying attention to even the tubers and the recreational users going down the river.
But firefighters aren't always around, and when they are called to help, it's often too late.
We treat it like it's very dangerous. This is a play park that is real water, real runoff. There are real dangers, there's real boulders. The water level can rise, it can decrease at a moment's notice, and you need to be prepared for that.
Compared to this time last summer, the current is tame, moving about 1,400 cubic feet per second on this particular day. CSFD says the Arkansas River peaked on June 4th of this year, and the highest flow was measured at 2,600 CFS. But water flows are far from the only threat. This tuber can be seen getting caught in a hydraulic, which is when you get stuck under the surface and recirculating water. The other big concern is getting trapped under the water by something you can't see on the surface.
Trees, there's branches. So when the water level does get high, it knocks off those debris and branches, causing objects to float in the water, which can be dangerous. Right here, you don't see it, but upstream, there could be a piece of debris floating downstream that we're unaware of.
After a full day of training and experiencing the risks firsthand, I know many people will still get in Colorado waterways this summer. If you do, please always wear a life jacket, have someone with you, and weigh the danger threat before you jump in. In Canyon City, I'm Bryn Carman, KRDO News Channel 13.